A chain restaurant. Item number, SCP-785. Object class, Keter. Special containment procedures. If periodic global searches of governmental records report the registration of any restaurant with the phrase Uncle Blank's blank in its title, a containment breach is to be reported to both the supervising researcher of SCP-785 and the leader of Mobile Task Force Beta-3, Takeout Diners. MTF Beta-3 is to secure the restaurant, SCP-785-2, and prevent any civilians from entering or exiting. Following the lockdown of the immediate area, a 5-kilometer radius quarantine is to be constructed around SCP-785-2. All civilians inside the quarantine are to be interviewed and administered Class A or B amnestics on a case-by-case basis. The restaurant owner and all individuals knowledgeable about SCP-785-2, or its origins, will be personally interviewed by the overseeing Level 4 researcher. Following the interview process, the Foundation is to ensure that all media reports will have the restaurant name, SCP-785-1, altered. Due to the extensive amount of time required in resolving a SCP-785 containment breach, it is advised that Standard Cover Story 12, Gas Leak, be deployed. Only the current leader of MTF Beta-3 and the overseeing researcher of SCP-785 are to know the full title of SCP-785-1. During containment operations, all operatives must have equipment possessing real-time sensory modification software that prevents them from either reading or hearing the full title. If either individual is suspected of leaking SCP-785-1, an immediate interrogation is to be conducted. For purposes of experimentation, one instance of SCP-785-2 is to be contained inside Site-23. Only D-Class personnel are permitted to interact with it. Description: SCP-785 comprises any restaurant with a name containing the phrase Uncle Blank's blank. The restaurant name is designated SCP-785-1. The actual restaurant is designated SCP-785-2. Propagation of SCP-785's effects will begin if SCP-785-1 is mentioned during conversation in a large public area, such as a movie theater or sports arena. Within 1 to 6 months after this occurs, an individual who had been present at the location where initial seeding was performed will establish an instance of SCP-785-2. It will be located within 0.5 kilometer of the location where SCP-785-1 was first mentioned. The personal preference and ethnicity of the founder influences the resulting instance of SCP-785-2, allowing for a wide range of possible restaurants. For a complete listing, see document 785-blank. Following initial seeding, a separate founder will not create a new instance of SCP-785-2 unless all previously existing and publicly known instances have been shut down. Left unchecked, the popularity of SCP-785-2 will grow unusually quickly. The Foundation has never observed fewer than 14 new instances within 9 months. The spread of SCP-785-2 is not limited to its home city. When first discovered, blank instances of SCP-785-2 were found in 3 separate cities. The effects of SCP-785 will manifest annually on the first Friday of May, when SCP-785-2 will advertise a spring special. All customers and employees of any existing instances of SCP-785-2 will be affected. Starting between 1600 and 1830 hours, any customers who had previously consumed any of SCP-785-2's beef or bread during that particular day, designated Group A, will report to SCP-785-2. Customers physically unable to report are exempt from SCP-785-2's effects. Staff will proceed to stab the members of Group A 12 times, always using a bronze-tipped spear coated with data expunged. All materials, save the data expunged, can be found in a typical chain restaurant. After all members of Group A have expired, employees will place their bodies on the floor. They will then turn off all appliances and produce 6 polyvinyl chloride, PVC, basins of water. All customers still living, designated Group B, will be issued a large knife, which is invariably composed of a bronze and blank compound. Using only their knives and their hands, all members of Group B will begin to consume the bodies of Group A. Every 30 minutes, they will wash their hands using the PVC basins. The meal will last for 3 hours, until all the basins have been used. Group B will return to their homes after the meal is finished. Employees will burn the remains of Group A using the same data expunged mixture used previously. After the completion of all activity, members of Group B will behave normally. Most members have a somewhat inaccurate recollection of the evening's events. Customer reviews of SCP-785-2 have typically skyrocketed after this event. Addendum 785-A. Despite the Foundation's best efforts to remove SCP-785-1 from public knowledge, instances of SCP-785-2 continue to arise. It appears to be impossible to apprehend all civilians who unwittingly spread SCP-785-1. Furthermore, the possibility of a deliberate third-party propagation of SCP-785-1 cannot be eliminated.